Now we see sixth experiment of video Android app development list. In the sixth experiment, create two files of XML and JSON type with values for city, latitude, longitude, temperature, and humidity. Okay, we need to create here two files of XML and JSON with values city name, latitude, longitude, temperature, and humidity. Next, develop an application to create an activity with two buttons to parse XML and JSON files. Okay, see here, there are two buttons to parse XML and another to parse JSON. And when you click on parse XML data, it should display content of XML file. When you click on parse JSON data, it should display content of JSON file. And the data should be displayed side by side. In case these are all text views, and this is the button, this also text views. Okay, now here we see how we can perform this. In the new application, we code, we start design from the beginning. Okay, at the beginning I remove this existing text view. Okay, or instead of removing existing text view, see, I'm going to tell you how to code in XML to create different text views. Okay, now you can see here the design having parsing XML and JSON data, parse XML and parse JSON data. And here in another activity, okay, you can either create another activity or in the same activity you can display. Okay, in the same activity you can display. And to do that, yeah, first we have to design text views. Okay, you can copy paste the same thing, or you can try to code using XML. Okay, using XML you try to code. Like this, text view, and see, it is automatically giving Android layout width and Android layout height. Okay, what layout width and what layout height you are going to give, that you can see how you can give. Okay, by using this content, wrap content. Okay, wrap content. See, once you click on this, okay, see, just you need to type text view. You have to select text view. Okay, automatically it displays a wrap content or match parent. You can select a wrap content, and for this also wrap content. Okay, and then next is what text or what label you are going to give. You can tell Android, and then you can select a label. Okay, or text. See, there are lot of options here. You can select particular label. Okay, by using text QRST, here it is alphabetically given, Android text. See, and then inside this, if you want to give some text, you can give the text. See, according to the design, the first is parsing XML and JSON data. Okay, you give parsing XML and JSON data. Okay, and next, what about the layout of text view? for the purpose you can select app. Okay, constraint layout indicates it is related to what constraint. Okay, constraint layout bottom to bottom of, instead of that, you know, there is a text box existing in the design. Do you want to keep the new textbook related to that text box, or do you want to keep the new text view but box or text box related to parent? Okay, related to parent means Android border. You can select the layout constraint. Okay, bottom to bottom of. Here we have to give bottom of parent. Okay, we have to give bottom of parent. Okay, now as we tell here bottom of parent, it takes it as bottom of parent, and that is the position of the current text view. Okay, that is constraint bottom to bottom of indicates bottom of text view, second text view. Okay, bottom of second text view is at the bottom of parent. Okay, and then what about see, you have to fix two handles of the text view, one vertical, another one horizontal. Means you have to now fix left handle of the text view. Okay, as you select app and then colon, you can go and select constraint. Okay, constraint, layout constraint, layout constraint. Either you can select baseline, or you can select left. Okay, constraint left, GHIJKL. Constraint left 2, it is asking constraint left of the text view to right of what, you can select a parent. Okay, like that, two handles you have fixed. Okay, and if you want to close this code, you can just close. Now there is no ID for this text view. If there is no ID, because here also there is no ID, here also there is no ID, you should give ID to this text view. Okay, what ID you can give? To give the ID, you can select here once again app, you can see what are the options for ID. What is the option for ID? If you can't get here ID option, what you can do now, you can select some existing code and you can go to XML code, and you can tell Android colon ID. Okay, Android colon ID is the option for giving the ID. Okay, app Android colon ID. And if there is spelling mistake, then also it won't take. Okay, Android. Okay, Android colon ID. Yeah, here it is, ID. Okay, equal to @, you can select this ID, and then you can give ID as text view 2. Okay, or text 2. Okay, like this. So this is a minimum code you need to do for another text view. If you see the design now, okay, design should reflect whatever text box you have placed. Okay, if you can't see the text box here, then you can see what is the problem. Now you can see the constraint, that is left margin you have to set. Okay, if you are not getting the output, you have to set a left margin, because here in the design left margin, as we drag and drop, left margin, bottom margin, top margin go on changes. Okay, with respect to parent, because we have given here constraint, layout constraint, bottom to bottom of parent indicates text view buttons or text view boxes bottom should be connected to bottom of the parent, indicates this bottom is connecting to bottom of the parent and left is connected to left of the parent. Okay, that we have to give here app layout constraint left to left of the parent we have given, and then we have to give left margin and right bottom margin. Okay, see, you can give left margin, bottom margin by Android, then layout margin left, layout underscore margin left. Okay, it's already given, therefore it's not showing once again. Okay, you can also give margin right, margin start, okay, which is already given here. Okay, if you remove this, it shows how to set left margin, layout margin left equal to left margin, you can give 100 dp or 100 pixel, 100 data points. Okay, and bottom margin you can change to instead of 316 you can give 200, and you can see in the design it is changed related to this. Okay, thus in the coding we can design the interface. Okay, if you are familiar with the XML coding, you can easily do that. Now if you want to create a button, okay, in the XML code, using XML code button, okay, and see, as soon as you tell button, it gives layout width and layout height. Okay, you can select wrap parent or wrap content. You can give wrap content or wrap parent. Okay, I have given as wrap content. Okay, and next you can set height of the button as well as margin, everything. Okay, and two more important constraints are how you are going to fix the button. Okay, where you are going to fix the button? Are you going to fix the button with related to parent? Then you can copy paste the same thing. Okay, that indicates constraint bottom to bottom of parent, means bottom of the button to bottom of parent, left of the button to left of the parent, and then now we have to set margin. Okay, left margin and bottom margin, both we have to set, and also we should give ID. How to give ID? To give ID, Android, then ID, Android ID, this bar, button or BT, you can give any ID, BT. Okay, and then you have to give left margin and bottom margin. Okay, same thing you can copy if you want, and you can change the value, or you can type Android underscore left margin. Ok, Android layout left margin left equal to, you can give, because there you given 100 dp, here also you can give 100 dp, and bottom, okay, it overlaps. If instead of 100 dp you give 200 dp, and bottom you can give same margin, because it places that in the same row. If you give the bottom margin same, okay. Now if you see the design, you can see the button is placed, okay, in the same level of text, because bottom margin is same. If you want to change the left margin, if you want to increase the left margin as well as button label, not there, if you can give button label also, okay, you can increase the left margin. Instead of 200 you can give 300, and you can give a text to the button, okay. Android text we can use, Android text, button, okay. Now you see design, see button is displayed. This way you can design the interface using the XML code. We have already designed the interface for this project. We will open it instead of designing using XML. I'm going to show you interface as well as code. Let us go through the interface which is given here, and there is two buttons and one text view which shows the heading, and these two text views for showing XML data, these two text views to show XML data, and two text views to show JSON data. And you can see the code, you can design with the code also, okay. If you want, you can design with the code. Keep in remember ID, and these are all minimum constraints, okay. And see, when you are going to fix a button to the bottom of existing text box or existing text view, then you have to give ID, okay. Constraint top of the button to bottom of text view, okay. And then start of the button to start of the parent, okay. This is passing XML data text view. You can see this passing XML data top of the text view to top of the parent, okay. Left of the text view to left of the parent, and here this button fixed to, button stop is fixed to bottom of the text view, and this fixed to left of the parent. You can see in the coding, okay, text view coding is this, start of the text view to start of the parent, and top of the text view to top of the parent, okay. Like that, see, layout constraint start to start of the parent in the button 2, B2. You can see in the design, this is button B1, this is button B2. See, start to left of the parent, or left to left of the parent you can give, and then top to bottom of the ID, this ID. Okay, that you can see here. Top to bottom of B1. Okay, in this way also you can choose the position of the different interfaces. Okay, and ID also you should give. Okay, if you go to code, main activity Java. First we need to create XML file. How to create XML file? To create XML file, we should create assets folder, and in that we have to create XML file. Okay, you have to right click on app and then select new, then select folder, then select assets folder. Okay, and then it is asking target source set is main. We have already created the asset folder. Okay, once again if you try to create duplicates, therefore just select the cancel. Already we created assets folder. Okay, and in assets folder you have to store XML file. What you have to type in XML file? You type some data this way. For example, see, this is data regarding student. Yes, I have given very simple data, one student data with the city and humidity. Okay, see this XML file, whatever you create. First you have to create a XML file in the desktop or somewhere. How to create XML file? First you select new, then create a text document and open this text document, and then save whatever XML you want to type, then select file, save as, and then from text you select all files during save as and give std2.xml as the file name, then save. Okay, now you created XML file. Here it is, exists XML document. Now you copy this file and go to Android. There right click on assets folder, there you select paste. It's asking copy of file, this in this path refractor, select refractor. std2.xml is available here. In similar way you have to create JSON file also, but here I have created JSON file in the program itself. Okay, as a string I have stored JSON file as a string. Now how this code work? You know there are four text views we created and two buttons, and there is a JSON string, okay, which is having data in the double quotation curve bracket open, and if you want to give data student, that is a string. In double quotation, if you want to give once again double quotation, you have to give backslash double quotation, and here backslash double quotation, then colon. Okay, colon to separate the element, because this is a root element. In under this root element, city name. Okay, and then city name is label here, which is given once again in double quotation with backslash, then colon, then city name, next comma, next land 2, colon, then longitude. Okay, like that. Longitude value, see here. This is a element longitude which is having value 56. 56, no need to give in double quotation. City name, because it is string. See, this is one element which is provided with the double quotation everywhere. Therefore, you have to give backslash double quotation, backslash double quotation. Here, city name is closed in colon. Nice. Okay, like this. You need to create JSON file. Okay, here JSON file is stored as string and all the interfaces are mapped, and for button there is a on click listener event, and here how it works we will see. If button B1 is selected, this is for XML parsing. Okay, how to get XML file? See, inside a try block it is written because we are going to use document build factory. Okay, first we have to read or open student.xml from assets folder. For that purpose there is a function get assets, then dot open which file, that is student.xml, and it is stored in the stream is. Okay, is is now referring to student.xml. then now to parse XML we are going to use DOM model, that is document object model. For a purpose we need to use document builder factory class, and we have to create instance of document builder factory, and this is object of document builder, that is dbuilder, and this is document object by using or by parsing is, by parsing the student.xml file which is stored in is, doc object is created. You know doc object having parsed XML file in the tree mode. That tree contain elements, that is root element. Root element is student. Okay, for first that tag name need to be chosen. Tag name is student. It will be chosen by using get elements by tag name, and node list is list of node, and nList is the object. See, node list is a class name, nList is the object. Because if there are multiple student records, then that will be stored as list of objects, and from the list of objects, that is from multiple student record, you have to select a particular student record. Now I'm going to select a 0th student record, because first student record, by using nList object dot item, that's the first record. First record is stored in the node object. Now if that node object, that is if node dot get node type is element node, okay, if student is element name, element node, if it is element node, then we have to get sub elements of those element name. What are sub elements? To get sub element, once again see, we have to use object of the element, and by using get element by tag name, city, city is the tag name. Okay, city is the tag name, and from city, first city you have to display, you have to access, that is city dot item of index 0 gives first city, and then after that see, if there are array of cities, there is also option to store that array of cities in the node list, but we are getting first city which is having only one item. Okay, that item we need to select by using node dot get node value. Okay, get node value dot to string, and t1 dot set text. In the case city we are setting as T1 text. Okay, because the student data record having different elements. Okay, first we selected city, now we are going to select humidity. Okay, and that humidity, once again it is first element. In the humidity it is there is only one element that you are going to select. Okay, by using node list 2 dot item of 0, and its value is assistant set as second text box value. Okay, this is about parsing XML. Now if you go to parsing JSON, it's also very easy. You have to select JSON object reader, new JSON object. In is the string where JSON components are stored. You already seen that in having JSON record. In is a string. Okay, now here JSON objects is equal to reader dot get JSON object student indicates the first object student will be stored in the sys, and then from that student object first element is a city name. Sys dot get string city name will be accessed, and value of the city name is stored in the city. Okay, this is the element name, and value of the city is stored in the city, and it is set as text box text. In the same way, humidity also accessed by using sys object sys dot get string. Instead of humidity, see here longitude is selected. If you want to store humidity as is humidity, you know that humidity is another element here. Okay, here there is no humidity. Instead of that, longitude is given. Longitude is another element. If you want humidity, you can make it as humidity. And same element name you should select here. Humidity. Is the spelling is proper? You have to give proper spelling. Humidity. Okay, dot. Here also humidity, and here also humidity. Humidity. Okay. Humidity you are going to select, and setting the value of humidity value as fourth text box. In this way this program works. It's very easy. Okay, you can try to access different student records by storing number of records and number of elements. Okay, now if you try to run, if there is no error, it starts running. We can see passing XML data. See, the interface is open now. If you click on this, it shows the XML data, that is city. Okay, and it should show humidity value. Okay, if there is such element, now element is wrong, I will show you how to correct. If you select passing JSON, it displays properly JSON data, city and humidity. But here XML data, no, second element is not displaying. Okay, JSON data it is displaying properly, JSON data. XML data is not displaying properly, second element, because I have changed here one element. You can see here I have changed the element as humidity. That humidity element should exist in student.xml. Is it exist? See, the case of the humidity, that is small. Same case sensitivity you have to follow. Same case you should follow. Same case you should follow. Give H as small here. Give H as small. That's all. That's only the error. Once again, rerun. Okay. Rebuild so that you can see the result, proper result. Now, once again, go to this. Unselect passing XML data. See, it's displaying city and humidity properly now. Passing JSON, showing city and humidity of JSON data. Because in JSON data, it's given humidity as 50 here. 56, it's displaying the same data. In XML, it's given humidity as 70, it's displaying the same data. Whatever element you have given, same element you have to follow in the XML. Okay. If there are more than one record, that also you can display. Here there is only one record of XML with only two fields. And in the problem statement, they have given to show longitude, latitude, temperature also. Okay. You have to create these three additional fields in the XML as well as in the JSON. And you should modify the code. For simplicity, we have not put those codes. Okay. And it is given as the assignment or improvement program for the students, so that you can add additional code here to assess longitude, latitude also. Okay. In the same way as well as in the JSON, to assess longitude, latitude. And in JSON data also, you should provide longitude, latitude. And in XML data also, you should provide longitude, latitude. Okay, work on this. If you get the result, it indicates you have understood.